word. Now you say you're saved, act saved.
Amen and
amen. Say you got a Holy Ghost, it ought to move sometimes.
Right.
It ought to show some signs.
True.
Yeah, this type of is right.
Come on, Pastor.
True.
You may be rejected just like Noah. In the 7 verse, you may be rejected because of who you believe in. You may be rejected because of what you believe in.
All right.
But just believe. Don't let nobody deter you from what you believe.
Amen.
Your obedience makes people, their disobedience, stand out. Mm-hmm. They be looking at you funny, but they the ones, the reason you look funny because you make their disobedience stand out.
Glory.
That's why we are unique and peculiar people. They look at us all crazy, strange, when they the ones that's looking crazy. Amen.
Amen.
Remember, if God asks you to do something, He will give you the necessary strength to carry out that task. If God asks you to do something, just like He did Noah, He's going to give you the power, the ability to get it done. God does not ask you to do anything that you will fail at. He does not ask you to do anything that He does not anoint you to do. He does not ask you to do anything that He don't put His stamp of approval on. But what we do, we go without God asking us to do anything. We try to do it on our own. Oh, glory to God.
Come on.
Verse 8 talks about Abraham. You have to activate your faith. Look real quick at 11 and 7 and read the first 2 words that you see. Everybody.
Through faith.
Read the first 2 words that you see in the 8th verse.
By faith.
Read the first 2 words that you see in the 9th verse.
By faith.
Say it loud. Read the first 2 words that you see in the 11th verse.
By faith.
Read the first 2 words that you see in the 17th verse. 20th verse. 21st verse. 22nd verse. 23rd verse. 24th verse. 27th. 29th. 30th. 31st. So are you getting it in your spirit now? How are you going to come out of what you in? By faith. How are you going to make it what you're going through? By faith. God said everything that you need, said just believe by faith that I'm going to do just what you need. He said all you got to do is have faith because if you trust in me, everything's going to be all right. You got to get that feeling deep down on the inside of everything is going to be all right. He says you got to activate your faith. He says stop letting your faith sit there like dumb and you going through your knees, God. He said by faith.
Glory, glory, glory.
Thank you.
Some of you been wondering how you going to make it out of what you want. He just told you right there.
By faith.
How am I going to make it? By faith. How these bills gonna be met? By faith.
Glory.
Do you believe?
Glory. Glory.
He says, just believe.
Yes, sir.
The 11th verse blessed me because it said through faith. Most of them said by faith.
Mm-hmm.
Right in the midst of your doubtful situation, God says believe. Right when it looks impossible, He says believe. Here in the 11th verse, the writer used through faith, meaning during the whole of, meaning to and including, because of, if through faith, it means into at one side and out the other side. Somebody should have shouted right there. God says you might have entered your situation on this side. He said, but by faith, just believe that through your faith, you're going to make it to the other side. He said, do it just have faith in everything you face. You will be able to go through by faith. You don't have to get stuck in your situation. You don't have to get stuck in your trial. You don't have to get stuck in your storm. He said, right in the middle of what you're going through, He said, through faith, you're going to come out on the other side. And all the storm said, there is a bright side somewhere. And through faith, if I keep trusting God, through faith, if I just keep believing, I shall get to the other side. I know it might not feel good where you're at. I know it might not look good in the middle of it. He said, but through faith, you're going to make it to the other side. Oh, glory to God. Well, what do y'all know? He said, what are you saying, preacher? While you are seeing unbelief with your physical eyes, believe the possible until you get to the other side of your situation. God says, don't you dare give up in your storm. He said, don't get caught stopping in your situation. He said, just believe. He said, have faith that everything will be all right. He said, just have faith that I'm going to do just what I said, because my word will not return unto me void. God said, have faith and believe and watch the transformations of your life. Oh, glory to God. He says, without faith, it is impossible to please me. He says, if you believe, then you can take that same word, impossible, and make it, I am possible. Because the Lord says, I am that I am. He said, there is nothing impossible for me. He said, all you got to do is just believe. He said, just put it in my hands and watch me work it out. Let me do it. He said, everything that the devil means for you bad, he said, if you just believe that I'll work it out, he said, in the end, you shall have victory. I know the enemy tried to make some of you feel like you was beat and defeated, but the devil is alive today, because he told me in the word that I have a victory through Christ. I have a victory because of my faith. I'm going to make it out by faith. I'm going to make it out through my faith. Why? Because I believe in the God that I serve. I believe in the God that sits high and looks low. I believe in the God that saved me a long time ago. I believe in the God that told me that I was going to be the head and not the tail. I believe in the same God that my mom and daddy said. But I believe because not of what he did for them, but of what he's doing in my life. I believe because of what he's done for me. I believe in me because what he told me, what he going to do. You see, you ought to praise God right now for what he going to do in your life. Before he done, I heard the psalmist say, you don't have to wait till the battle over. Shout right now. Today, anything is possible with the Lord. But he said, all you got to do is just look to the hills from the coming to your help. All of your help comes from the Lord. So I tell you, when trouble comes in your life, start looking toward the hills. I tell you, when trouble start coming in your life, I just believe in God's word. I just believe what he said, I am that I am. Believe that he said, I'm going to bring you out. Why do I want to climb when I can speak and it got to get out the way? I believe.